As long as time has gone on, there have been good ideas and there have been bad ideas. Very, very bad ideas. I'd say there's a lot more bad ideas floating around than good ones by a pretty significant degree. Here's the real question though. Can a bad idea plus some time become a good idea? I mean, just look at Captain America if you'd like to become a believer.
Would you please pull over the car? I am going to get sick.
Are you okay? Don't leave me out here!
If they stopped when it seemed like Cap couldn't be saved, moviegoers would know him as the guy that stole cars. Back on topic though, in the Grand Library of Hockey History, there's a volume that describes a truly horrible idea. That of a puck with illuminescent blue glow, looking like a sad cloud always hung over its head, or when moving quickly took on more characteristics of kind of an orange skid mark. I'm of course speaking of the fabled, the mostly hated yet sometimes loved and always fascinating, Fox Track Puck. Graphics are cool. I don't really know any other way to say that. I'd like to muse on it for a little while, but really they're just cool. For example, the strike zone outline during a baseball game, or the contestant's name and country during an Olympic sprint. I'd say best of all though, the first down marker during an NFL game. It looks like it really exists on the field, not hovering over but planted directly onto the playing surface. It's informative and helpful, but not too cluttering. Really, it's the perfect aid to help newcomers understand the sport. Wonder who made that technology. Anyways, that's how graphics can be used as a visual aid for new fans, but it can be used in so many other ways. Some of which are purely aesthetic but lead to a really interesting way of seeing the game in a new light, while also allowing the community to be involved. A great example is the rise of sports edits, aka transplanting, say, basketball players into more pop culture mediums like making a player go Super Saiyan from the Dragon Ball Z franchise. This also works on a lower scale by giving them generic superpowers to ascend them to a different level of visual appeal. This is exciting because at the end of the day, sports fans have seen most sports highlights before, even if they haven't. Great catches, deep threes, and one-timers are all more like snowflakes than you'd think. All different, but incredibly very similar. This is a great way to jazz the entire thing up and create a new and unique perspective to each highlight. We're getting a little bit off track though, so let's get back on track and talk about the Fox Track Puck.
Scientists at Fox Sports Laboratories are working on new technology. You won't believe your eyes. On January 20th, you will witness the biggest technological breakthrough in the history of sports.
In 1994, Fox Sports won the rights to televise NHL games. Concerned their new viewership couldn't follow the small puck moving so quickly, they enlisted an in-house company called eTac to install sensors in the puck and to develop technology to track it. The idea of a blue glow that would turn red, leaving a tail as the puck moved faster than 70 miles per hour, was agreed on. This was their solution. The technology ran from the 1996 All-Star Game to the end of the 1998 season. Unfortunately, it diced hockey fans pretty much down the middle. The newer half enjoyed the accessibility it added to their viewing, while more experienced fans referred to it as a childish embarrassment to the game. Fox would lose the rights to broadcast NHL games for the 1999 season. They'd reallocate the team that developed FoxPuck to, oh, would you look at that, trading the first down marker for the NFL. Initially, that would garner a split decision among fans, but the technology was so much more useful in that sport, Fox would elect to keep the program running forever. Later, they'd break away from Fox and form a company called PVI. Most on-field aids run for all sports nowadays are either made or pioneered by this company. Let's get back to hockey though. Ultimately, it was a failure. The option to strive towards enhanced viewing only created resentment among the population. To most, this would be considered a tragic misstep in the league's history, yet the NHL has announced for the 2019 season they will once again be utilizing augmented reality technology, including sensors under the players' shoulder pads to track movement and new special pucks outfitted with sensors. This is all thanks to a German company called Jogmo World. Not the best name. Is this a good idea, though? Well, let's look to history beyond Captain America's Grand Theft Auto.
Are you okay?
Phenomenal CGI for films has never been more dominant in its culture due to advances in technology turning what used to be stale genres into absolute spectacles. Furthermore, advents of technology have made previously useless instruments into downright amazing creations. Is it fair to ask new fans that are just learning to follow a tiny black disc going over 100 miles per hour across an entire ice surface littered with blind spots? No, it's really not. But is it fair to tell established, longtime veterans of the sport to cope with an ugly, garish design they don't need? The answer to that is also no. If both answers are no, then how do we proceed? Do we all remember science class because a Mr. Nye, a science guy, taught me that two negatives make a positive? So the answer to the NHL's augmented reality question is actually yes, but under only one condition. It needs to be toggle enabled. So wily puck followers don't need to be burdened with odd glows or needless info, but when switched on, new fans get a leg up on knowing what is going on. As your parents probably told you growing up, compromise is usually the best solution. The NHL should look to proceed forward with options for both the old and new fans, making nothing permanent for each. Yet, some fans will always hold in their heart a special place for that ridiculous glowing puck, because in truth, occasionally, it was amazing. But truly, like Car Thief Cap, it was a legend of the past, only to be replaced by something much, much better.
That defeats Steen, that didn't connect, back the other way comes Smith, he's got Carlson looking to join him. Smith over the blue line, left side, not a Carlson, and he scores! Ryan Carlson's first of the year, wins it at all!